Welcome back to my channel. Are you working in Power BI in an enterprise-grade scale? Have you ever wondered how to share your semantic models that have either row-level security or object-level security with your report writers, and you do not want them to access unauthorized data or objects? If the answer is yes, then this video is for you. Hi, I'm Sohail Bakhshi, a Microsoft Data Platform MVP, with a very warm welcome from biinsight.com. In this video, I'm going to explain the right way to grant access to Power BI semantic models for contributors who are generating reports on top of a shared semantic model in your Power BI and Microsoft Fabric environment. Let's say we have a shared semantic model that a group of people can connect to and create new reports. But these report writers must have different access rights on the same semantic model. Let's take it one step further. Let's say that my semantic model has row-level security and object-level security applied to it. We do not want the users to have access to everything in this semantic model. As you may know, when you have a corporate workspace, the users that have any roles on this specific workspace other than viewer role can access the underlying data on the semantic model. So how can we grant permission to this semantic model for the report writers so that they can only see the relevant data but still being able to create their reports? It sounds a challenging scenario. Let's get to it together. To efficiently grant access to shared semantic models with either row-level security or object-level security in Microsoft Fabric, there are a couple of steps that we have to take to achieve the goal. Let's navigate some of these key concepts that are required to get this setup right. First of all, we need to know what are shared semantic models. The concept of shared semantic models relates to understanding workspaces. In Microsoft Fabric and Power BI, we have corporate workspaces and personal workspaces. The corporate workspaces are containers that we create our items that are related to our work environment. While the personal workspaces is usually used for personal improvements or learning, so on and so forth. It really depends on your governance framework and governance policies. The concept of a shared semantic model is when we have a semantic model in workspace A, which is serving a report or a couple of reports in workspace B. The end users will access the reports from the workspace B by having viewer role on the workspace. The report writers are the ones that have contributor role under workspace B and create reports in this workspace. The report writers also need to have build permission on the semantic model or a viewer role on workspace A. This requires a little bit of settings in your Fabric admin portal. I will walk you through that in today's video as well. The second concept to understand is the roles on corporate workspaces. There are four roles on corporate workspaces. Admin role, which is the highest privilege on the workspace. Members role, one level down admin, still really high privilege role. Contributor role, which is one level down member role, but not as much as the member and admin roles. Last but not least is the viewer role, which has read-only access to the reports and dashboards on a workspace. Why this is important? We need to go to the next point, which is understanding row-level security and object-level security. The row-level security and object-level security topic is a really vast topic, and there is no time in this video to go through all the ins and outs of how we implement it and how it works in detail. But we really need to understand that we implement row-level security and object-level security in our semantic models. Who is doing that? The developers of the semantic models. They create rules that will be applied to users after the semantic model is published into a workspace. Best practice is always to use security groups to assign these row-level security or object-level security roles to a group of people instead of individuals. How does it relate to the roles in a corporate workspace? Here's the thing, both role-level security and object-level security only kick in for the users who have viewer right on a workspace. And that is the tricky part. If you assign a user or a security group as a contributor role on a workspace, they will have access to everything in your semantic model. They will see the entire data and all objects within the semantic model. And that is exactly what we do not want. The fourth point that we need to understand is about the permissions on the semantic model. I will put the documentation link down below. On the semantic model's permissions, the report writers will require to have read and build permission. As I mentioned earlier, RLS and OLS kick in when you have viewer role on a workspace. It also kicks in if you have read permission on a semantic model. But for report writers, they need to have build permission on a semantic model as well. So to keep it simple and wrap it up, to enable the report writers to create reports on top of a semantic model, which is sitting on a separate workspace, you need to either give them viewer permission on the entire workspace. But what if the workspace has some contents that you would not like the report writers to access other contents either? So the read and build permission specifically on the semantic model would be required. With that, let's begin. The concept of sharing semantic models is simple. We need one single source of truth. So we share a semantic model for others to be able to create reports on it. There are a couple of options to do so. Let's have a look. I click on it, and in the semantic model page, I have share semantic model button that I can click on it and share it with others. From this page, I can set the permissions for the recipients, and the recipient can be individuals or security groups. As mentioned earlier, best practice is to do it via security groups. I will share the link down below that explains what these permissions are and how they work. But for now, let's say that I want the users to be able to only create reports on top of this semantic model. So I do not allow them to modify the semantic model. I also do not want my recipients to be able to reshare this semantic model with others. So I take that off as well. And I'm not also interested in sending email notification. From here, I can start typing individual account names or security names. So I start typing PBI report writers, which is a security group that I created earlier. And I grant access to the PBI report writer security group. So now we expect that all members of this security group to be able to access the semantic model and create reports. Let's see how it works. Now I log into Microsoft Fabric with another user. The name of the workspace that contains the semantic model is Mark 8 Project Team. As you can see, Megan, which is this user, do not have access to this specific workspace. So can she create a report on top of the semantic model that she already has been given the build permission? Let's have a look. I go to another workspace that Megan has access to, and in here I click on new item and then select report. And from there, I click on the pick a published semantic model. Let's see what she sees. The semantic model that is being shared with her doesn't show up here. This issue relates to a setting in admin portal. So Megan has to communicate with Fabric administrators to fix this issue for her. On the other side, the Fabric administrator needs to go to admin portal by clicking on the gear button on top and then click admin portal. And on the tenant setting, search for semantic models. This is the setting that we are after. As you can see, using semantic models across workspaces is disabled. So what we should do is to expand that and enable it. In real world scenarios, the best practice is to enable this for a security group. But for now and for the simplicity, we keep it enabled for the entire organization, and then I click apply. Now when Megan comes back and refreshes the page, I would expect her to be able to see the semantic model that is being shared with her. Let's pick a published semantic model. As you can see, there are a couple of semantic models that now Megan has access to, including this one, which was the one that we have shared with her earlier. So now Megan can just simply select the semantic model and click create an automatically generated report. And this is automatically generating a report for Megan on top of the shared semantic model. There you go, that was simple. Now Megan can save this report by clicking save and giving it a name. If we go back to this specific workspace and select the consumer website traffic report, then we can click on the view item lineage to see the lineage. As you can see, it shows that this report sits in the sales and marketing workspace while it is sourced from a semantic model that is in Mark 8 project team, which is exactly what we wanted. So now let's take one step further and see how this mechanism works when we have role-level security or object-level security. Now I have a semantic model that has OLS or RLS or both of them enabled, but here's the thing, I do not want to give my report writers access to this workspace. So let's check on the workspace manage access. You can see that I have only Power BI administrators and sales and marketing who has only viewer access right on this workspace. The other security group that I would like to be able to create reports is Power BI report writers. I can quickly show you in here on M365 Admin Center. I have created a report writers security group, and Megan and Alan are two members of this security group. Now I need to give the Power BI report writer security group build permission. To do so, I click on the semantic model and from files, click manage permissions. From there, I click add user and start typing PBI report writers. Select the security group and give it the required permission, which is build permission, and I grant access. As soon as we do that, it adds this to the permissions. As you can see, Power BI report writers now have read and build permission. Now let's use Megan as a report writer and switch back to Megan's account and see what she can do. First of all, she has an empty workspace and she wants to create a report which follows RLS or OLS on the top of the semantic model. I click new item and then click report. From there, I pick a published semantic model. I select, instead of clicking on this button, I click on the drop down menu and click create a blank report. As you can see, for warning showing on top saying that this semantic model or data set has RLS settings, but you do not have permission. To fix this issue, we need to go back into the semantic model and add the PBI report writers to the required RLS or OLS roles. Let's do it together. To assign roles to RLS or OLS settings, we need to hover over the semantic model and click the ellipsis button and then click security. From here, we can see the OLS and RLS roles that are created on this semantic model. So in my scenario, all of these ones are role-level security, and this specific one is a object level security. Let's say that we want this group to only be able to see or access the sales, internet sales for 2013. So I just start typing and click add and then click save. I go back to my report writer's account and see what happens there. Now, if I click refresh, as you can see, the tables are now appeared here and I can go and select my, for example, a measure, internet sales, and from date, let's get calendar year. Let's turn it into table. As you can see, it only shows the internet sales for 2013. I want to grant access to my object level security to the Power BI report writers. Let's open these pages side by side to see what happens. Now we have two accounts open. So this one is my administrator account, which I'm going to make the changes. And this one is Megan's account, which is a part of Power BI report writer security group. I removed the report Power BI report writers assignment from this role and add it to the employee denied, which is an OLS role. Let's add it and click save. As soon as it goes through, look at the changes that has happened. As you can see, Megan can see all years of internet sales, and also the employee table doesn't show up anymore. You may ask, what happens if Megan saves this report and other people access this report? If the other users have read access to the semantic model and they are a part of a security group that is assigned to a row level or object level security and row level security will definitely kick in. So there you go, you have it. In today's video, we have learned the correct way to share semantic models. We have also learned that if our semantic model has row-level security or object-level security in place, we need to take some extra steps. And we also have gone through a specific scenario where we do not want our report writers to access the workspace that holds the semantic model. I hope you enjoyed this video and catch you in the next one.